Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn sum of series using for loop in Java. We had already done few patterns before based on series or kind of series which we had printed using the for loop. Now today we will use the same for loop to do the sum of the series. Let's start. Okay. Now if I want to print the sum of the series 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 and we have to go till n, how will we go about it? Okay, so let's see over here how we go. So over here I have a function and it is accepting an integer argument. This I can input from the user. Okay, this n can be input from the user also. Here I am accepting it as an integer argument. So n is a number till where I have to go. Okay, so over here I have taken one variable s is equal to 0 and a variable x. The for loop variable is x and I have to move from x till n. Why n? Because I have to go from 1 till n to find the sum of the series. Now, and over here I have taken a counter variable s which is actually storing the sum of the numbers. So if the user enters 1, the user enters 5, let's say, if the value of x is 1 initially, 1 is less than 5, yes, it is true. So it will come in and add 0 plus 1, so it will become 1, and it will go up again, it will increment the value of x and it will become 2, and it will continue like this till it reaches 5. Once it reaches 5, so in that case it has done by now 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, and now 5 is the value which is the value of x right now. 5 is less than equal to 5 because the value of n we considered as 5. So it is equal to 5. It will come inside and it will add. What it will add? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, it will add 5, and it will go up again and it is going to increase the value of x. Now the value of x becomes 6. But the condition does not fulfill because 6 is not less than equal to 5. So it will come out of the for loop and print the sum of the series, which is s. That is the sum which you have calculated over here. So when n is 5, the sum of series is 15. So if we add 1 plus 2, that is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 4 is 10, and 10 plus 5 is 15. So that will come to 15. So this is how we will calculate the sum of the series for the series 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. Now let's see the next program. Okay. Now over here in this series I have 1 divided by 2 plus 2 divided by 3 plus 3 divided by 4 and so on. Now children, since I have taken this as int, it will not show me in decimal numbers. If I wanted the sum to be in decimal numbers, since it is division, I could have taken it as a float or a double. But for the time being, I just need to program it for you so that you may understand the concept. For the actual value, you can take it as float also. Now over here, if I see the sequence, the first number, this is the second number, this is the third number, and this is the fourth number, fifth number, and so on. So the numerator is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if we see the denominator, it starts from 2, and 2 is what? If this is n, this is n plus 1. If this is n, this is again n plus 1. If this is n, this is again n plus 1. That means 2 is 1 more the numerator. If numerator is 1, denominator is 2. If numerator is 2, plus 1 will make the denominator, that is 3. So that is why I have written over here n divided by n plus 1. Children, in the examination, sometimes this part is not given, n divided by n plus 1. So you have to judge yourself what kind of series it makes. So 1, and over here it is n plus 1. And there would be definitely a similar pattern somewhere around the corner, and you have to figure that out. So once you have figured it out, see in this case I have noticed that the numerator is, if the numerator is n, the denominator is n plus 1. So we will start from 1 and we will go till n, and over here we are going to start from 1 more the numerator. So in this case, if I am talking about this case, I am taking the value, if the value of n is 5, so that means we have to go till 5 greater than 5 divided by 6. So s is equal to s plus, what is, what would be the next part? S plus x. What is x? 1. And 1 plus 1 will make it 2. So 0 plus 1 divided by 2 will make it, make the value of s in the first round when x is 1. When x becomes 2, when x becomes 2, it will go inside. Now the initial value was already 1 divided by 2, which was stored in the previous iteration. So in the previous iteration, 1 by 2 was stored in s, and now when it comes back, it will increment, it will become 2 and this will become 3. So 1 divided by 2 plus 2 divided by 3 will be the second iteration round. The third iteration, when x becomes 3, it will add 1 divided by 2 plus 2 divided by 3 plus, what is x now? 3. 3 divided by x plus 1. X plus 1 will become 4 and so on. And it is going to continue in the same manner. When x becomes 5, when x becomes 5 and n is also 5, so 5 is less than equal to 5, it will go and calculate it in the same manner and go up again and increment the value of x by 1, and it will become 6. When it becomes 6, it checks, is 6 less than equal to 5? No. So it will come and it will print sum of series is whatever the value of s is having at that time. So over here, since I have taken it to be an integer, so it is showing me the sum of series is 10. But if you take it as a float, it will show a decimal value if it exists. Okay, so let's move further and check the next program. Now over here, children, this is an altogether different program. This is a sum of the factorials of a number. Now you know that to calculate the factorial of a number, we require a for loop. Okay, so the inner for loop, if you see over here, just calculates the factorial of the number. And the outer for loop is used for calculating it from 1 till the value which is entered by the user as n. Okay, so in this case, if I have taken the value as 5, so 5 factorial would be, it will calculate the 5 factorial of 5, and then it is going to calculate the factorial of 3, then 2, then 1 plus 4, and it is going to add all the values and it is going to show the number. Okay, let's see how. Now over here, the value of x is what? 1. X is less than equal to 5, x plus plus. And you say f is equal to 1. We will see to it why f is equal to 1 is written here later. Okay. Now in the second for loop, it is starting from 1 and it is going till x. Now what is the value of x? 1. That means the factorial of 1 has to be calculated. So 1 factorial is 1 into 1. So 1 into 1, and you go up and you increment the value of y to 2. So y becomes 2, but x is 1. So it will come out of the loop and it will store the value of the factorial 1 in the variable s. S, which is 0 initially, plus f, which is 1 now. Okay. So now after this, the value of x will increment and it will become 2. So when it becomes 2, is 2 less than equal to 5? Yes. Now children, for this factorial, we need the value of f to be 1 every time. So if it has to be every time, we have to write down this f is equal to 1 inside the for loop. Because this f is equal to 1 will be every time the factorial is calculated. Now if we put it outside, the value which was earlier, which was calculated for the previous number, would be storing in f, and it is going to multiply it with that number onwards. But we do not want that. We want it to start from 1, because factorial is 1 into 2 into 3 till the number. We have to multiply starting from 1. So that is why I have taken f is equal to 1 immediately after this for loop. Now y is equal to 1, y is less than equal to x. What is x? 2 now. So y plus plus. So it will come, it will write down f into y. 1 into y is what? 1. And it will go up, increment the value of y, it will become 2. It will come down, it will say f is equal to f into y. Now the initial value of f is what? 1. Because 1 into 1 we have multiplied. Now it becomes 2. So it will become 2 over here. The value of f is now 2. And it will come out, it will increment the value of y, it will become 3. The condition will not be fulfilled, it will come out, and s is equal to s plus f. Now the initial value of s was 1. 1 plus 2 will make it 3. And now x will increment and x will become 3. X will become 3. Again the same process would be repeated, and the factorial of when x is equal to 3, the factorial will be 1 into 2 into 3, that is 6. So this will be 6 would be added to the variable, to the initial value which was there in the previous iteration, that is 2. So 2 plus 1 plus 6. 2 plus 1 plus 6. Or we can say 1 plus 2 plus 6. So that will make it as 9 right now. So it goes up again, and the value of x is incremented, and now over here the value of x becomes 4. When x is 4, the factorial would be 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. So that would be 12 into 2, that is 24. So 24 would be added to 9, which was the actual value in the third iteration. 24 plus 9 would be 33. So 33 would be storing at the end of the fourth iteration in the variable s. Now it goes up again, and it increments the value of x to by 1, and x becomes 5. When x becomes 5, it will calculate the factorial of the value that is 5, and it will actually calculate the factorial as 120, that is 120. The factorial of 5 is 120. How? 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5, that will result into 120. Now 120 would be added to 33, because 33 is the value which is being stored in the variable s now, as for the fourth iteration is concerned. So 33 plus 120 makes it 153. So that is why when we print the sum of the series for the value n is equal to 5, it will print the sum of the series as 153. So this is how we will do the sum of the factorial of the series. So I hope you have understood this, because this is the main thing over here which is to be noticed and have to be kept in mind, is that you have to use two for loops for such type of series, wherein one is actually for calculating the thing, that is the factorial, and the other is for moving from 1 till the nth factorial. And over here f is equal to 1. Why? Because for every number we have to calculate the factorial starting from 1. If I put it outside, like over here s is equal to 0, it is giving me the total sum. So it will give me the total factorial of all the numbers. So I don't want that. I don't want 1 to be multiplied by 2, then to be multiplied by 6. No, I want 1 plus 2 plus 6 and so on. So in that case, it will not work in the correct manner. But if we write down f is equal to 1 inside, then only it will work correctly. Okay, let's move on to the next program. Now this is an easy one. 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16 till n terms. The only thing what you have to figure out over here is to watch carefully what this series is. If I think about it carefully, it is something which I already know from quite a long time. This is 1, this is 2 square, this is 3 square, this is 4 square, and so on. So over here what I have done, I have moved from 1 till n, I have found out the square of the number and added it to the previous s, which was initially 0, and I have continued, and in the end I am displaying the sum of the series till the n terms. In the case of 5, it is 55. If I take n is equal to 5, the sum of the till n terms is 55. Okay, so let's move to the next program. Now over here I have a worksheet based on lecture 14, which is this one, and these are the programs which you have to do. Few of them are mix and match, which we have already done. If I talk about this program, this is a bit different, and this is, if you see, it is 1 upon 1 factorial, the numerator and denominator one which we have done, and this is 1 is positive, the odd number is positive and the even number is negative. So you have to see how to go about it. And in the same manner over here, it is the same thing. And this is first number multiplied by the second number. If this is n, this is n plus 1. So I've given you all the hints. Now I want you to do this program, all these programs, and then we can check out the answers of these. Okay, thank you children, and have a nice day. And if you like the video, kindly subscribe to my channel, and if you have any doubts, you can comment, write it in the comment box. Thank you.